हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन इंग्लिश क्लास। सो स्टूडेंट्स, लेटली वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एनालिटिकल पैराग्राफ एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ फ्यू मोर एग्जांपल्स ऑफ एनालिटिकल पैराग्राफ्स। सो बिफोर कमिंग टू एनालिटिकल पैराग्राफ एज अ फॉर्म ऑफ कंपोजिशन, वी मस्ट नो समथिंग अबाउट दैट व्हाट इज अ पैराग्राफ। Paragraph is a short form of composition that we have already discussed. It consists of a number of sentences related to one topic and in a single paragraph. But in a long composition, such as an essay writing, an article or a story, we have a number of paragraphs and we have this analytical paragraph in a long composition way. So, and thus a paragraph is an important unit of long composition, and as well as it can be short or long also. So we have lately we have discussed in our last one video about the effect essentials of the paragraph, what are the requirements of a paragraph, how you can write a good analytical paragraph. And today we are going to discuss few more examples of analytical paragraph. In last video we have discussed an example of bar graph, and today we are going to discuss this analytical paragraph, and today we are going to read a line graph, and with the help of this line graph we have to read this, and we will try to understand that how we can read a line graph if you will get a line graph in the paper, and how you can convert that line graph into a passage. So let's start our today's discussion on this analytical paragraph in the form of line graph. So here, as you can see, we have a line graph, and the question we have here is: the following data were released on the eve of Van Mahotsav Day. Interpret the data for the guidance of policy makers as well as for the awareness of common people in a paragraph about 150 to 200 words. Here we have to interpret this data very clearly, and here the guidance of policy makers as well as for the to create the awareness of common people. So as you can see here, the data interprets that for the guidance of the policy makers as well as for the awareness of common people in a form of paragraph. So we have to write on this topic, and here they have mentioned the year 2000 2001 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, and the two lines, one line shows the trees cut down, and the one line is showing here trees planted, and the number of trees are also mentioned: 2000 4000 6000 8000 and 10000. So we have to observe everything here, and at last we have to start writing. And the heading we can give here, the tree plantation for better environment, because the topic is of tree plantation. So we can write any common topic based on the tree plantation for better environment. So, and you can even start your paragraph by just jotting your own points on this topic, because it's a common basic topic. So we can start here, we can add up our points also on this tree plantation topic. It's a matter of concern that more trees have been cut down than planted during 2000 to 2009. After about 8000 trees were planted, whereas 1 lakh trees were cut down during 2009 alone. In the year of 2000, 6000 trees were cut down against 4000 planted. And over the years, the problem has become quite alarming, and yet no one in power is ready to accept it and deal with it adequately. So see, while writing we can do the here comparison in both the lines, then in which year, how many years were planted and how many years were cut down. So by doing the comparison we can make our notes here, and we can just may write our paragraph in a beautiful way, and you know, it seems really good that we have done the comparison. by mentioning the year and by how many trees have been cut down and how many trees have been planted. So it is so because with the rise in population, we need more and more land to build residential buildings, roads, bridges, etc. The developmental activities are being feverishly undertaken to provide material comforts to people both in the urban and in the rural area. So this also problem we can mention here also that the alarming rapidly growth of the population is also major reason here, major concern we have here this also, because the population is increasing day by day. It's and this increasing enhancement of the population is a very, very major reason that why trees are being cutting down. So the development is also the reason. We need area, we need wood, and we need to make roads and bridges. So we need material for all these things. So poverty forces a large number of people living on fringes to fell trees to meet their daily needs. So people, those who are poor, they are also cutting down the trees. They also used to cut the trees. Why? To survive up. They don't have luxury life. So what they are doing? They are cutting down the trees that surrounds them, that's nearby them. They are cutting down the trees and they are making their food. They are just making their bread with the help of the trees by cutting down the trees and so. So it is obvious from the rising line representing the number of trees cut down that our people are yet to become conscious of the importance of trees. Yes, it's true that people are just unconsciously cutting the trees. They're really not giving this idea or this thing a thought that why exactly we are cutting the trees or what would be the harmful effects of this cutting of the trees on the nature or on this world. They are just literally cutting down the trees without giving a thought. The cutting of trees only adds to environmental degradation. And it has resulted in global warming, which in turn is responsible for many of our ills, including shortage of rains, falling of crops, and extreme temperatures. So cutting of trees is a major reason that global warming is increasing day by day. And the shortage of rain that we all are facing now from last few years. Falling of crops also, extreme temperature that we all are facing nowadays. It's just because due to cutting of tree in a very, very massive number. So steps should be taken to plant more and more trees. Trees should be cut down only when and where it is extremely necessary, otherwise not. And even we shall plant more and more trees by taking the help of our neighborhood, by taking the help of our society, and by taking the help of our generation, nation, and government. So we can cure this problem. So see, here we have done the comparison of a line chart. Now next we have the next question we have here. So the following pie chart shows the result of the health checkup conducted in a school, interpreted for the school authorities in a paragraph of about 100 to 200 words. So now next we have an example of pie chart. So this is the example of pie chart. As you can see here, we have a circle, and here we have a different pattern, and they have done the segregation here by just giving it a name A, B, C, D, E, F, and each section has a different pattern inside it. So the lining pattern shows it's a normal, and this checkbox, it's written that this is shows that this is underweight category, and the stars are skin problem. Here few small lines we have, it shows this is dental problem. Here bricks pattern we have, it shows that eye problem. And here a whole blank pattern we have, it shows that this is obesity. So health checkup is our topic. So simply we can write a topic on health checkup. You can do this also. Just read the question and find out the main topic, and if you're not getting any idea, so you can just write whatever the topic is mentioned above. because it's written there, the following pie chart shows the result of the health checkup. So health checkup can be your topic. So we have written here health checkup topic, and now we have to just read out. So the vast area we have here is the normal people. Shows the A part shows is showing here, it's for the normal people. So from the pie chart it is clear that only 50% students of the school represented by A, because half of the circle is covered by A, so it's 50%. So from the pie chart we have this clear idea that 50% of the student of the school are represented by A, are they are normal in real in the real sense of the term, they are normal in condition. Other students suffer from various problems. 5% of the students in category B, they are underweight, they are obese, they are suffering from obesity. Those who suffer from skin problem and eyesight problems and obesity add to 10%. So students, you have to give the percentage of this, because 50% shows that students are normal. So other 50%, rest of the 50%, you have to divide by yourself, 5, 10, 15, as per the area they have covered up. So those who suffer from skin problem, eyesight problems and obesity add to 10% further. 15% student have dental problem, as you can see here. And the school can help these students in many ways. For the dental problems, school can organize that dental checkups for the students. It can engage a doctor or a team of doctors to provide medical treatment to the students, and especially to these students, those who are suffering from dental problem, and free or at the nominal rates. It can also invite their parents and ask them to treat them on their own. They can guide them. These students should be persuaded to take care of the personal hygiene as well. So they should be advised to eat balanced food, which must include vegetables, fruits and milk, and do regular exercises and consult the doctor. As most of them belong to poor and illiterate families, their parents should be taken into confidence about their problems. So see here, by taking the example with the help of this pie chart, we have to describe everything. We have to convert this pie chart into a paragraph. So students, you can get here line chart, pie chart, maps, figures, news, bar graph, and you have to describe, you have to change everything into a paragraph. You have to convert that information into an into a big paragraph. Okay, now I have one more example for all of you, and here as you can see, the following table shows population characteristics of four states A, B, C, D. Analyze the data in a paragraph of about 150 to 200 words. So here we have a table. In the form, we have a data, a survey, and it is in the form of table. So if you observe the table, first of all, it's written population characteristic of four states. Then in the table, they have segregated into four parts. They have divided this table into four parts. First of all, state, name of the states are A, B, C, D. Then total population in millions, 32, 15, 48. And then sex ratio, male female, 9, 7, 8, 7, 11, 9, 3, 5, and the literacy percentages, 65, 72, 69 and 82. So here you can do the comparison among states one by one, A, B, C, D, and you can do, you can mention the population of state one by one. You can do the comparison also among all these states. You can do the comparison of sex ratio and of the literacy percentage also. And simply you will write your, again, your topic as simple as it's given earlier, population characteristics of the four states. So it's your wish how you would like to describe the this table. One by one you will mention everything, or you would like to describe everything by doing the comparison simultaneously. So let's start. The given table shows population characteristics of four states A, B, C and D. The most populated state is C with 40 million population. And the least populated state is D with 8 million population. If we compare the figures concerning these two states, C and D, some interesting facts come to light. The literacy percentage of the state C is less than that of the state D. In fact, literacy rate in the most populated state is C and is the least in comparison with other states too. The least populated state D has the highest literacy percentage because the population is less, so people are literate there. Comparing its sex ratio with other state, it has more females than males. Because why so? The reason behind this, because people are literate there. An interesting fact. So it may indicate that the state C may have matriarchal system in which undue importance is not given. So what is the meaning of matriarchal? Means relating to or denoting a form of social organization in which a woman is the head. So here the matriarchal system in which undue importance is not given to the male child. So in all other three states, namely A, B and C, the number of male is higher than that of females. So which shows the usual patriarchal trend as is observed in Indian society. Patriarchal, where it's relating to the denoting or the social organization in the hand of man. So it's a usual scene in India. We have already a patriarchal system here in India. We used to follow up this, and it is quite clear then that in the most literate social society, people are quite aware of the advantages of less population, and they are not unduly attached to the male child in the family. So see, by observing this data, by observing this table, we can easily organize, we can easily made our paragraph, we can easily compose our paragraph just by keeping the data that is mentioned in our pie chart, in our graph, in our bar graph, in our table, in our map. So you have to just keenly, first of all, observe, just spare your 2-3-5 minutes, observe that paragraph, observe that type that you will get, and afterward you want to make the comparing here, you want to make the comparison there, or you simply want to just write or mention everything, the data that is given inside, you can make up your paragraph easily. And by doing the practice also, you will be able to do so. So students, next time we'll meet up with another topic, we'll talk about another topic. Until then, take care of yourself, do well in your life. Thank you.